So off camera, I merged the vendored gRPC Haskell as a vendored dependency. Now I'm going to go ahead and review this commit where I commit my changes. And it's early, so I'm not going to talk too much so I don't wake people up here. I see there's a merge conflict, so I'll have to rebase my local commits, re-upload, and then we'll see how things look from there. I think I want a separate commit for this workspace file. So I want to get rid of anything that's just related to rules of Haskell. Let's just commit a simplified one. I don't know if branching is going to work.
So this should just be the diff of the workspace file. Seems good. I would like a bigger thing to click on here. All right, so we've removed unwanted files. Or no, we haven't, have we? I guess I'll look at the README to make sure nothing's too crazy. Unfortunately, at this point, the OBS cut out. And while I have all the audio, I lost video for a few hours. And I think that's okay because I got what I really wanted to out of this episode, which was to get a handle on the rhythm of taking a monolithic change, breaking it up into manageable, reviewable chunks. And I think that I did enough of that where it's not essential that we see everything that went on. The original change got broken up into, I think, like 18 changes. And each one is relatively small. Some of them are extra small. We've got one extra large where I just removed a bunch of files. I think that's okay. But any one of these, I guess, like cleanup C imports is just, you know, you can click on it and it's just doing kind of one thing, small changes, so that when you look at it, it's not a ton of files. Each one is, in a sense, relatively easy to roll back if you need to. Although in this case, because I'm transforming the code from a kind of non-working state into a working state, a rollback would tend to break things. But that's just slicing things up and getting that rhythm right is really all I wanted to, the main thing I wanted to figure out for this episode.